Harvest. No. That's my 2 minute Tuesday alarm. It's just so that I don't miss a day. Yeah. All right. What's up, everybody? Peter McKinnon here. Welcome back to yet another 2 Minute Tuesday. So good to have you and see your smiling faces. Today's topic, we're jamming on something called color space. What is color space, Pete? That sounds confusing. Please enlighten me. I plan to. Let's throw 2 minutes on the clock. Let's go. I'll try not to go over this week. So let's start with the basic question. What is color space? Color space is essentially the range of colors that are available to your camera. That's done in RGB. So that stands for red, green, and blue. And all the colors that your camera captures are some kind of combination of RGB. Now, when you're shooting with a camera, you can actually change that color space within the menu settings. It should come stock as sRGB. That's a smaller color space than the other option, which is called Adobe RGB. Adobe RGB is a larger color space, which most people would think, hey, I'm gonna go with that one because it's gonna give me more colors. However, it's primarily made for people who are doing lots of print work. So if your stuff's going in magazines and newspapers and billboards and galleries, shooting in Adobe RGB would probably benefit you more because it's based more on the CMYK spectrum, which is cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. But what a lot of people don't know is when you start mix matching these color spaces is when you run into issues, which is what happened to me last week. So I did some research to figure out why this happened and learned that you should be syncing your color space across the different apps that you're using and your camera so that your work looks consistent across the board. So if you shoot a lot of media for the internet, which is what I do, most of my work lives online, I should be shooting in sRGB. Because even if you shoot in Adobe RGB, when you upload that to the internet, it's gonna change it to sRGB anyway, and then that is gonna mess with the colors of your photo. So I'm gonna show you how to change that in your camera, Lightroom, and Photoshop right now. So if you're shooting raw, it doesn't really matter anyway, because when you're in Lightroom, Lightroom assigns the color space when it exports the photo. So for example, you come over here to File, come down to Export, and you'll see if we slide down to File Settings, color space right here is set to sRGB, which is good, good to go. Now if we open Photoshop up, go over to Edit, Color Settings, you'll see at the top, that's also set to sRGB. I had mine set to Adobe RGB. It was exporting as sRGB, and then I was loading that into Photoshop with Adobe RGB, and I was having that color difference problem. Solved that by syncing these two up. Same thing goes for your camera. It's the fourth option on the first menu if you shoot Canon. You come over here and you hit Menu. I'm already selected on color space. You can see, boosh, right there, we've got two options, RGB, or Adobe RGB. I'm gonna keep this on the default, which is sRGB, because like I said, if you post this online, it's gonna be converted anyway. So that's it for me today, guys. I hope you liked this video. I hope that's a helpful tip. I love that actually it happened to me last week because it forced me to look into it a little more, and I feel that it's information that photographers and people that print their work and put stuff online should know anyway. So I'm pumped that happened and I was able to share that insight with you, be that you knew it already or you didn't. However, hit that like button if you like this video, smash it if that's something that you're into, subscribe if you aren't already, and I'll see you guys next week.